Hi guys, my name is Janmin Lisandra, and today I will be demonstrating on how I painted this painting. So first of all guys, you need to subscribe to my YouTube channel in order to see all my coming videos and tutorials.
It is a colorful painting with a barn and lots of flowers. Okay guys, but before that, I'm going to introduce to you first my materials. I have here my paint palette. So I have the titanium white, the tallow blue, the medium red, and the brilliant red, the medium yellow, and the lamp black. So you always observe guys that I am always using limited colors in my palette because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. Okay. And these are my brushes. I have here the 1.5 inches flat brush. You can also use 1 inch guys or 2 inches. I have here also number 7 flat brush, long handled. Number 4 flat brush, long handled. Number 11 flat brush, short handled. Number 6 fan brush, long handled. And I have a liner brush number 1 guys. For the details, you can also use a line brush or no, a round brush. Okay. And this is my canvas guys. It's 12 by 16 inches. It has 3 coats of prime gesso I made myself. And I have here a water guys to tint the paint. So I'm not using any medium guys rather than water. Okay, so first I think we're gonna start with the sketching. So I'm gonna do the sketching first guys before we're gonna start the painting or the background colors. Okay. So I'm gonna use the number 4 flat brush. I'll be using I think blue, so I'm gonna use the blue guys for the sketching. So you need to wet your brush guys. If it feels hard, so just dip the tip of your brush into the water to make it a little wet, and so that it will flow freely into your canvas. Okay, so I think I'm going to put the barn here. It's just a very small barn guys. You can actually use another color guys, brown or any color you want for the sketch. You can also use a pencil or whatever you want guys, as long as you are comfortable using it. So I think I'm going to add some water, body of water here, like a swamp or a river. Okay, so that would be my plan. So this will be my barn. And some rocks. It's gonna be a bigger barn guys. But I'm going to cover some part here. Yeah, with some trees, colorful trees. Yeah. So that will be my plan. Okay, so I'm going to add some grasses here, lots of grasses in this part. I think we're gonna add the tree here, if I have a time, guys. So I'm gonna put some tree here. Okay, this will be very I'm going to add lots of plants on this painting. Okay, that's it. So I think this will be okay to me. So I think I'm gonna start with the painting now. Okay, so I think I'm going to start now with the colors, background colors. So I will be adding the background colors, guys, first before adding the details. Okay, so I think I'm going to mix for the lighter blue for the sky. I'm gonna expose a little amount of or some part of sky here, guys. Okay, that's it. So I'm gonna add a little amount of blue. Okay, then I'm going to add lots of green. So wait. Okay, so I'm going to wait. And now I'm going to start mixing for the green color. So I'm gonna do first the background green colors, guys. So I'm gonna need the blue, yellow, and a little amount of red. It's a little blue green, guys, not really green. So this will create a sense of distance, guys. Or a perspective. Okay, now I'm gonna start adding some darker green color with red and that's a blue. So this part, guys, will be a little darker. We're adding some more dark colors, or not adding a white to it to make it dark. Okay, so you just have to blend it well, guys, here and also here. Okay, that's it. Okay, what else? So here also, I'm going to add some more green. Okay, so here also I'm going to start adding some darker green color. So I'm gonna mix more green. First, guys, you just have to play the colors. So you see, guys, that the stroke is really visible. So it doesn't matter, guys. You just have to enjoy and play the colors. So I'm gonna mix first, and I'm going to mix another dark color here. So I'm gonna make this part dark. So I'm going to mix for darker colors. So it doesn't matter, guys, what color you're gonna put. I'm going to put some black, red, and blue to make this part dark. So that's it. So I'm gonna mix another green color here. So I think I'm gonna refill, guys. Now I'm gonna mix another green color. I'm gonna add a little amount of red with yellow. Okay, so if you wanna paint with me, guys, just follow everything I'm gonna do with this paint in this video or this tutorial. So just follow, guys, and don't afraid. Okay. So here also I'm gonna add lots of trees here. Cover some part of the pine. Okay. Now I'm going to add some lighter color here, blue green, to create some reflection on the water, guys. Okay, so you just have to put some lighter blue green here, like this color here. On top. Okay. What else? So I think I'm going to make this part dark. With dark green, yeah, dark green with blue, red, and yellow, of course. With I think lots of red. This will be our reflection later, guys. So we're gonna fix it later. So first we're gonna put some dark color here. So we're doing now the blocking, guys. They call it the blocking of colors, so that you will know we're gonna put your subject or whatever you can get your planning and your painting. So I'm gonna put some black. So it's okay, guys, if it's not not smooth. Yeah, that's it. What else? So I think I'm going to start adding some brown color on this bar. So I'm thinking, guys, to put the light on the right side. So this will be my first time, guys, on my tutorial to put my light. Or yeah, I don't know if I'm going to put it here or here, so I will be planning it later, guys. So where I'm gonna put the light, so if it's right, so, or if it's on the left. Okay, so I think I'm going to mix for the brown color. Okay, so I have here the yellow and the red, and of course the black to create my brown color. Okay, so you just have to play the yellows, the black, and the red, guys, to create this dark brown color. You can use a smaller brush, guys, if you're having trouble using this big brush. So I think I'm going to make it lighter with yellow. So this will be our barn here. So if you're not paint with me, guys, just follow everything I did or what I'm gonna do in this tutorial. Or what I'm doing in this video, guys. So I'm gonna make it lighter, guys, with brown and white to make it lighter. So you just have to apply the, or to you just have to adjust the color or the values of your dark white and black color, guys, to make it to adjust the value. So if you want to make it darker, just add black. If you want to make it lighter, just add white. Hey, and here also. Okay, so I think I'm going to mix for another color. Okay, that's bad. So I think I'm going to shift for another smaller brush. So I'll be using this smaller brush, guys, to prevent another accident. But don't worry, guys, if you encounter this, so it's okay, guys. You can still correct it. You can still cover it with paints or another color. Okay, so I think I am done with my first coatings, guys, or the base colors of this tutorial. So I'm gonna let it dry first for at least 5 minutes, then we're gonna go back and adding more details on this painting. So just follow, guys, and keep watching. Okay, guys, so I think the paint is already dry now, and I'm going to start adding the details. So I think I'm gonna start on the barn, or on this part of the background. Yeah, I think I'm gonna start on the background first here, then I'm gonna do the barn and this part. Okay, so I think I'm gonna use a bigger brush, and I'm gonna start with on the smaller brush, and I'm gonna start with the number 7 dot brush. Okay, so I'm going to add some trees here in the background. So I'm gonna use the blue and yellow to make some green and red. Okay, so I'm gonna add white to make it lighter, guys, to create for the highlights. Okay, so here we have now a lighter color, so I'm gonna do the tapping technique, guys, here. So I'm gonna add more white to make it lighter, guys, and yellow. Okay, so there will be some, what do you call this, ground here or grassy fields. Okay, you can use your fingers to smudge. I think I'm gonna use the fun brush, guys, to create some tree leaves here. So I'm gonna use this one. I'm gonna use the white and the yellow and a little bit of blue. More white. Now you can use the edge of the fun brush, guys. And here also, I think, guys, I'm gonna add the lights on the right side here, on the right side. So let's add more highlights here. Gonna add darks. So I forgot that this part should be dark. Okay, and also here I'm gonna add some yellow color, guys, yellow highlights. So just tapping technique, guys, or punching. Okay, so you can smudge using your fingers or blend using fingers, guys. I think also here. I'm going to add more white to create more highlights. Okay, and I'm going to add some green, guys. So I just add green, blue to make it more green. Then let's add more highlights here. Okay. Yeah. Not too much, guys. Too. And also here, this is the technique, guys, the tapping technique or punching. Okay. And I'm going to add here also. So, I'm gonna make it more gray, yellowish, guys. Okay. Yeah. In a way, we just have to cover this area, so it doesn't matter, guys. Yeah. Okay. So I think I'm going to add more dark colors. Wait. So I think I'm going to cover some area on the top with some dark colors. So I'm gonna mix for darker color, guys, with some blue and white. So we just have to blend the colors here. Actually, you can leave it that this way, guys. I just want to make it darker. That's it. And also on this highlights, so just kill the color or blend it. So actually, guys, I am blending the colors to make it not so obvious. Okay, so you can follow what I'm doing, guys, if you wanna paint with me. Okay, so we just have to smudge or to blend the colors here to make it lighter or darker. It doesn't matter. So it's a circular stroke, guys, on my brush, at the tip of my brush, to create some tree-like effect like this part. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so it doesn't matter about this part, guys, it will be covered anyway. Okay, so I'm going to start adding some more details, I think, here. So I'm gonna do first the dark colors with blue, red, and a little amount of yellow here, so make it dark. Okay. This will add this will add some depths on this part. Okay, I think I am done with that part of the background. So I think I'm gonna do the barn now. Okay. So just follow everything I did, guys, in this video, or what I'm everything I'm doing here. So I'm gonna use a pure white here. So I'm gonna make this part really white. Okay. Okay, that will be the roof part of the brown rice, then I'm gonna mix for the brown color. So I'm gonna use the yellow, the black, and of course the red, with more yellow and white to make it lighter. I'm gonna make it lighter brown, guys, and I'm gonna add more yellow to it to make it yellowish, and white to make it lighter. Then just have to apply it here directly, so it will be vertical stroke, guys, from top to bottom. Okay, that's it. So just follow my strokes. Okay, so I think this is just a very easy tutorial, guys. Okay, about that. So don't fill it up, guys, leave some more spaces. Then we're gonna add more lighter color with more yellow. So again, guys, don't fill it up, just put just make a light strokes like what I'm doing to add some more details or textures on the barn. Okay, so just have to create a light strokes, and also here. Okay, that's it. So I'm gonna use a smaller brush, guys. I'm gonna use the number 4 fat brush to for the lighter for a lighter color out of for the smaller strokes. So I'm gonna use the black and the red to create some darker brown color with yellow. Okay, so I think I am enjoying this tutorial, guys. I hope you also enjoy. Here also, I'm gonna put some dark to make it darker. Hey, that's it. So I just have to create some lines here. Okay. Let's see here. Okay, and also here, this will create the shadings, guys, or shadows of the barn. Okay. About that, and also on the top here. Okay, and then add also here and here. Yeah, we have now a barn. Okay, I like it. And we're gonna add some dark tones on here, but I'm going to do first this part here. I'm gonna put some dark color, so I'm gonna use the yellow and black, guys, to create the base of the barn. Okay, gonna move it up. Okay, So actually guys, there are actually no almost special technique and painting this one. You just have to follow what I'm doing to put the right shadings or the right textures, then we're gonna achieve the realistic effect. So I am more a realist, guys. I am actually a realist artist, so of course you'll see in my painting that I am painting mostly realism. Okay, yeah, and I'm gonna use a smaller brush. No, later I'm gonna fix it first, everything on this barn. So I'm gonna put some also details here, guys. So I'm gonna use again the number 7 flat brush, then I'm gonna mix for grayish color. So I'm gonna use the black and white only, with a little amount of, not only guys, but a little amount of yellow, and it's still brown, but I think it should be darker. So here, adding more yellow to create more yellowish effect. So just apply it there. Yeah, and also here. Okay, here also, and here also. So again guys, it's a vertical stroke, so you can blend using your fingers. Okay, about that, then we're gonna add a little some bluish color or bluish tone. So I'm gonna use the blue guys here with white and black to create the bluish gray color, and then we're gonna apply it here. Okay, and also here. Okay, and then I'm going to add more dark color, dark tones here. Okay, yeah. So here, yeah, about that. And I'm going to mix for a lighter brown, guys. So I'm gonna mix just this one with red, yellow, and blue. Oh no, yellow and white and black. Then let's have some brown color here. Okay, I think I'm going to add now the color of the roof, so it will be light, guys, very light in color. Okay, so I'm gonna use this white, and I'm gonna add more white here to create more light color. It should be lighter than the wall, guys. Okay, you can apply it vertically, guys, unlike the on this wall. Okay, that's it. So you just have to apply it gently. Okay, and here also. So okay guys, I just fill it up with the brown or light color. Okay. Yeah, how about that? And then I'm gonna use this brush, guys, the number 11 flat brush, short handled, and I'm gonna add more details. Okay, so I'm gonna use this white, same here. I'm just gonna put some more details here. Okay, and here also. Okay, how about that? On top of it, just gonna add more white, a lighter color, guys. So I'm gonna use white. So just a random vertical or horizontal stroke, guys, like what I'm doing. Here also. That's it. Yeah, that's it. Then we're gonna add details on the this part of the wall. So I'm gonna use the black with a little amount of yellow and red to make it brown and white. So don't make it so light, guys, just dark or dark brown. So you know, add some horizontal strokes. Make sure, guys, that make sure that it's equal in size, but if you commit mistakes, so it doesn't matter. I just have to continue making these strokes. Okay, and also here. Okay. Yeah, that's very nice. And I think also here, but I'm gonna make it darker, guys, so just add black to it to make it darker. Then I'm gonna more black to make it darker. Okay. Okay. Now we have no outline. So, and also the roof, guys, we need to add the details on the roof, but it should be lighter, guys, so I'm gonna use the more yellow and red and white. So just horizontal strokes. Create the details of the roof, guys. Okay. So here, just make it light, guys. Don't put too much dark on it. Or don't not make it too dark. Okay. Yeah. I think I'm almost done. And I think I'm going to make it this part light, guys, because this will be the part that I'm gonna put so much light on it. It will be my subject, guys. And I'm gonna add more white, guys, color here with some yellow and red and more yellow. Alright, okay, this is it. So it will be so light, guys. Yeah, and here also. just add the horizontal strokes. Okay. Yeah, how about that? Oh, that's very nice. Yeah, this will be a part of the back of the barn, guys. So actually this barn is facing on the other side on the back, so yeah, that's it. Yeah, okay, so what else I'm gonna put? I think I'm going to add a window here, so I'll just use the black, guys, with a little amount of yellow, and I'm gonna put some window here, just a small window, guys, a square window. Okay, yeah, that's it. Yeah. And I'm going to add some irregularities to this part. Okay. And some more white here. Okay. It's too wet. Okay, so I think I'm content with this, guys, so I think I'm going to proceed to the other part. Okay, so now I'm gonna use another brush, this number 7 flat brush. So I think I'm gonna put some more details here with some rocks. So again, guys, the brown, I'm gonna use the brown again here with red, yellow, and black. In some white to make it lighter, so let's add some rocks here. Put some rocks. I'm gonna make it gray, yes, guys, with yellow and white. Okay, here also. Okay, how about that? Then we're gonna add more green color here, there. So I'm gonna use the yellow, of course. Then this this blue to make it green, and red and yellow again. So just tapping technique, guys, or punching on this part. To create some plants or bushes. Okay, then I'm gonna add the yellow, guys, to create some highlights and white. More yellow. So just tapping technique, guys, or punching. Okay. Okay, that's it. So don't overdo it. Just okay. Now a little clear, guys, and we're gonna add more white here to create more light color on on our rocks. These brown rocks. Okay, yeah, so what else? So I think I'm going to start adding the the reflection. Okay, so I'm gonna make I'm gonna mix for a darker brown, guys. So I'm gonna use this brown on the that we use here. Okay, so just have to create some horizontal. Just have to copy this part, guys, here. So just horizontal strokes, but make it light, guys. Make it soft. Okay, so just make it soft, guys. We just have to just like glazing, making some light or what do you call this, transparent strokes or transparent colors. And also here, gonna put some okay. So just continue making these strokes. Yeah. And I think I'm going to add more lighter color, so just add white, guys. Okay, and then I'm going to use this color here. Then I'm gonna add some reflection or rocks or stones. Then we're gonna add green, guys, the existing color green here. Okay, then of course we're gonna add more dark color, dark bluish, guys, that dark blue here. We need to add a little green, guys, to make it greenish. Okay, how about that? I think I'm going to add a little brown here on the dark side. So just smooth color, guys. Do not overdo it, just smooth color. Okay, yeah, that's it. And then before I forget, I should add some dark, so make it greenish, guys, green color here for the what do you call that, for the window, or for the window. Yeah, I'm gonna make it greenish. Yeah, I think it really looks like realistic now. Okay, so I'm gonna add more green color here, more green and black, and a little bluish here. And also, guys, here also gonna mix for another lighter color here. So just glaze it, guys. Okay. Okay, that's it. So you should glaze it, guys. Don't push it too hard to create this kind of effect. Okay, so that's it. Yeah, I mean, anyway, we just have to cover this part later, so just have to leave it that way. Okay, so I think I am done with that part, so I think I'm going to move now this area and also this area. So going to I'm going to add the highlight, you know, the reflection on this part. So I'm gonna use the yellow, guys, and the total amount of blue and white. So here, okay, too much white. Yeah, and it also in the background plants. Just have to create. I just add a little amount of yellow skin color, but you don't have to to make it obvious. Hey, that's it. What else? I'm thinking of adding more here. I think of adding more light color here, so I'm gonna use the yellow and the white and the blue, guys, with black, and just have to apply it here again, guys. Horizontal strokes. Okay, so let's continue adding the horizontal strokes, and we're gonna add some rifle effect. So we just got to create some another that was a vertical stroke, and this will be the horizontal strokes to create some waves or rifles. Okay. Yeah, that's it. I think it looks realistic now. Okay, so I think I'm going to add the tree here. So I'll be adding some area here, land area, what they call that. So I'm gonna use the black, guys, and the yellow. Just have to apply it here directly. Then we're gonna add some highlights and yellow, red and yellow, to create some rock or soils. Okay. Then we're gonna add some plants, guys, or grasses on that part. So we're gonna mix for green, so yellow, blue, and red, and blue again, and red, no, yellow, to create some more plants. Okay, so I think we're gonna let it dry first. Then we're going to use the fan brush, guys, here. This fan brush. And the blue color and the red. I'm gonna make it dark, so I'm gonna use the black. Okay. Okay, just cover that part. Okay, so I think I'm going to add some reflection. So I'm gonna use this green with a little amount of dark color. So just have to create some reflection, guys. So again, guys, the vertical strokes. So I'm gonna add the reflection on this area or land or island, what do you call that? Okay, and also here, I'm gonna add the horizontal ripple. To create a wave like rifle, guys. Okay, and I'm gonna make it dark, so I'm gonna use the black. Okay, yeah, that's it. Okay, now let's add some tree on that part. Gonna add some tree here, so I'm gonna use the black and the white, guys. I'm gonna mix it here, so I'm gonna make it that way. This will be again an old tree, guys, so I'll make it a regular, guys, in the size or in the body. So just like you're playing the body, guys. Can add black and gray, whatever you're gonna put. Okay. I'm going to add a little amount of yellow and some branches. So I just have to do it this way, guys. Okay, and black, some more black. Some branches. Okay. And I think I'm going to add some bluish, guys, so I'm going to use the blue and white. Okay. So I'm going to add some, I'm going to tap some blue color here. To create some more, okay. Yeah, what I thought about that. Okay, so now I think I'm gonna proceed here. So yeah, I'm gonna proceed that part to make it faster. Okay. So I'm gonna use the yellow guys here, and I think I'm gonna make it this part, this plant an orange, so I'm gonna use the red. Yeah, I'm gonna like the orange guys. So you can use the fan brush, and you can use the tapping technique or punching. Yeah, I think I'm gonna add more red. And I think more yellow. Okay, so red and yellow. Gonna be a really huge tree, guys. So just tapping, guys, tapping technique. So also here to create some grasses effect, guys. Also, I'm gonna add more yellow. Just gonna add more brushes here. Yeah, I think it's gonna be very fun, guys, painting. Okay, I'm gonna add more dark color green here. Dark color with red and blue and yellow. So gonna add more grasses here, guys. Long grasses using the fan brush. Okay, so I think I'm gonna add some light green color here. And I'm gonna add more blue and over yellow. And blue and white. More white. Okay, just have to play the colors, guys. Okay, and also tapping technique, tapping and punching. Okay, about that, then I'm gonna make this gonna add the highlights on that, on this orange plant, guys. So I'm gonna use this red and yellow and of course white and more yellow. Then I'm gonna add it here again, guys. It's punching or tapping technique. So that's it, just the tapping technique, guys, to create this effect. Okay. Yeah, about that. So here. And here. Okay, and I think I'm going to add some highlights on the ground. So just add white, guys, the pure color. And then just pull it up, guys, quickly or smoothly. Just make a vertical strokes from top to bottom to create some grasses like textures. Okay, I'm gonna make this part really okay. About that, and then we're gonna add the highlights and the green color on the here. So just add white guys to make it lighter. Okay. Okay. About that. Yeah, I think I am almost done. So what else I'm gonna put? So I'm gonna add more retouch. I'm gonna add more yellow guys. Yellow and some white. So again here. Okay, so again guys, the tapping technique to create this tree like grass like effect or textures. Okay. Okay. Now we're gonna add some river punk here. So I'm gonna use this orange color here. Yeah, I'm gonna add some black and white. Should be some riverbank guys. Okay. I'm gonna add more white, yellow, and red. More yellow. Okay, so we have no river bank. Yeah. And then you should not forget the reflection. Okay. So what can you see, guys? Yeah, I think this is really a beautiful painting. And I think I'm going to add some branches here. So I'm going to use the same brush, and I'm going to use this black and white guys to put the gray light color, and I'm going to put it here. Okay. And then this can add more white to create some highlights. Okay. More white guys. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put some more. You can use actually a smaller brush, guys. The liner brush, or you can use the liner brush for these details if you're having a hard time using this this big brush, fat brush. Okay. Yeah. Actually, guys, it's not very colorful painting, but I think it's still for me it's still a colorful because of this orange trees or tree leaves. Okay, and I think I'm going to make this fire tree, so to make it more colorful. Okay, so I'm gonna use this red color here. Yeah. Yeah. To add some flowers on this dead tree. It's not dead anyway because it has flowers. Hey. And also here. Okay, I think I'm going to add some yellow to add more little highlights. And I think white also, guys. Yeah, I think white. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, how about that? And I think I'm going to add some still have a little amount of time, so I think I'm going to add some more white what do you call this, white flowers here. So I'm gonna use this white color, guys, here to create some more white flowers. And I'm using the liner brush, guys, a round brush for this. Yeah, also here. Okay. You can actually skip this part if you don't like adding flowers in this painting. And here also. Okay. I think I'm gonna add more here. Okay. Okay guys, so I think, wait, one more. Okay, that's it. So yeah, I think that would be enough guys for these paintings before I'm gonna overdo it. Okay guys, I think I am done with my painting demonstration today, so I hope you get something in my painting tutorial, a quick painting tutorial guys. I think this is just more than 1 hour or 1 hour and 15 minutes. So if you want to paint with me guys, just follow everything I did in this video. And my advice guys is to keep on practicing, keep on painting, keep on doing it. The more you do it, the more you know how to mix the colors, and the more you know how to use your brushes. That's a very important part guys in learning how to paint. And I'm saying guys, thank you so much for watching this video today, and once again, thank you very much and have a nice day.